Right now, there could be a person walking around with a piece of plastic that has your credit card information printed right on it. Credit card cloning is on the rise locally. Information breached by big retailers and new apps have made it a lot easier for criminals to steal your account numbers. And our investigative reporter, Jennifer Lukey, joins us tonight with the real deal. Just one more thing for us to worry about, Jen.
It sure is, Liz. These are just a couple of the surveillance photos of people who've used clone credit cards over the past few months in just the town of Colony. Credit card cloning is a growing and major issue everywhere, and even though your bank may cover the unauthorized charges, we're all paying for it still.
Scammers that hack our credit card numbers normally put them up for sale online. All a buyer needs is about 50 bucks in equipment and a plastic card, and they can make it look just like the one in our wallet.
Because it's very easy, it's very inexpensive, and in most cases, they're not tracking down every single person that clones.
In Colony, the number of people using cloned cards has skyrocketed. These are just some of the folks the department is looking for.
We definitely have, you know, dozens and dozens of these cases. We have several investigators that are working on it.
Believe it or not, most of the unknowing victims had their cards breached months, if not years ago.
Home Depot, Target, we talk about these major breaches, but they were a while ago now. There's still active cards from those breaches.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Because what the system is flawed in a number of ways, but one of them is that your bank isn't going to cancel your card proactively necessarily until they experience fraud.
And normally that fraud comes on fast and furious.
In a lot of these cases, they're actually washing their money, laundering their money by taking these counterfeiter clone cards and buying large quantities of gift cards.
And cloners are now more aware of security features that could put a cramp in their operation.
Some of these more sophisticated rings, that's what they've done. They are able to identify by zip code or the personal information where that card would most likely be used, and they'll actually travel to that area so as to not raise a red flag to try and milk that card for as much of the credit that it has.
Although credit card companies normally cover the fraud, we're all still paying for it.
If you were the credit card company, would you just eat this expense? No, you wouldn't. You'd build it into your APR, you'd build it into your annual fees, you'd build it into something else.
Now, local police departments are working with retailers trying to get clerks to ask for ID when someone uses a card, to contact managers when multiple cards get declined before one is accepted. Those are just some of the hints that it could be a clone card. Now, newer credit cards do have chips in them that should help protect against this type of thing if the cloner is attempting to use the card in person. But it won't help if the card number is used to purchase items over the internet.